Practice imperfect. Many other but Carl. Hello, everybody. Carl here. I've totally forgotten about this fishy plane here, the Sukhoi Su-9, the Sukhoi Su-9U, the NATO reporting name of Maiden. It's a two-seat trainer aircraft, and it can go up to Mach 1.7 or Mach 1.8. And it can do these kinds of jobs. Yes, I've totally forgotten about these two interceptor aircrafts, the Sukhoi Su-9U and the convertible version, which is a trainer. Wow, look, it's so snowing in here. Yes, let's look at Sukhoi again. The interceptor variant, and you can see it right now. Some green part. This is the Sukhoi Su-9, the NATO reporting name, Fishpot. And it's a convertible variant from the Sukhoi Su-9U. And to convert this, you need some handful of money, as well as 1 hour on the 9U. So, just the comparison statistics. The Sukhoi Su-9U, the Su-9U, the 1950s trainer aircraft, Soviet Union, and this is the interceptor variant. This has two seats, and the interceptor has only one seat. So, two capacity means it can do transport flights. And the convertible version, you need 1 hour on the trainer. It will reduce the capacity to one, and it becomes a full-blown interceptor, so there will be no transport jobs. When you convert to this interceptor, so 22 kilometers more of the range, and 90 knots more of the maximum speed, and yes, one less capacity. So that's it. The Sukhoi Su-9U, the Su-9U, the NATO report name is Maiden, and the Su-9 with Fishpot. And then enjoy the next video. Well, hello everybody. I'm Carl. Welcome back to this simulator / RPG game, Aeronautica. A few moments ago, a new update has been released, version 1.89. Just one day before this 1.88.2. Take the time to pause the video to read this short update. So, the first airport to be remodeled is Amaras Regional. Here's a Bombardier Canada Regional Jet 200. And seems to be less detailed from the wings. But you can see the bottom part of the top, as you call it. So there's still the columns, the platform. Control tower. Parking spaces, as with the Anhedral International. Pushback carts. I think they have to park it like slanted. Right, the parked AI aircraft. While we wait, there here's the concurrent players. I was just notified of this update half an hour after the release. And that is Amaras Regional. Now let's teleport to Clarence International. Which plane can we use? Just this A340, the B747, the Gulfstream, or the Lockheed U2 from somebody else. Alright, let's try the Gulfstream. What is the significant change at Clarence International Airport? So all the jet bridges have been replaced in this terminal. Oh, here are the jet bridges. What a handful of them. Why is this happening? More jet bridges. The ones without the general aviation terminal. Yeah, it should be here, or this should be the cargo terminal. Is this? Oh, there's some passenger planes. Which one is for the cargo? The smaller aircraft, the general aviation. I should have looked at that. This is the remodeled Clarence International. A bit of an improvement. Where can you park an Airbus A380? Or a 777-9? It's intended for smaller aircraft. And that is that. The newly updated Clarence International Airport. So where is this Embraer remodel? Yes, the C-390. It's, oh, that's where we were. Let's go back to Hip A. And the plane we've used when I spawned. The Super Tucano. Here's the Embraer C-390. Brazilian military transport. It's not 0.03, it's 0.06. So color one is the body. Color two is the wings, the horizontal stabilizers, the engines, and color three is the vertical stabilizer. And the trim, the engine like that, it's just white. Should have been darker. Should have been using the darker versions of, oh, this is 165, 176, 171. Aircraft gray. The C-390. Or its equivalent in Portuguese. So where's this Eagle Estate? Let's go back to that Gulf Stream from Clarence. Here it is, Eagle Island Estate. It's southwest of Biscar. No, yes, southwest of Harden. This is Harden. And that's just east by northeast of Castellanal. Oh, it's that Tupolev ANT-28. Alright, so how can we get to this new island that has recently been risen? Let's try another corporate jet. Let's look for a corporate jet we can find. Can Oconee reach with the Avanti? Let's see if it does. Corporate flight to Nofberg. All right, 4.7 minutes. From Oconee. Kilometers. All right. Let's add the sound. All right, so we'll be taking a normal transport flight from Oconee to Eagle Island State on the P-180. shall we? And here is, once again, the statistics for this turboprop corporate transport. The Piaggio P.180 Avanti. E1. Let's follow this British airspace. What do you call it? It's like Avro something. Yes, the BAE 146. Yes, British airspace. BAE 146. Congratulations. I hope someone would remodel this soon, because still in the basic quality quality there. And Call 3 shouldn't be much on the wings. It can't be a secondary line, while Call 1 should be close to the aircraft. Right, we're now at 1-way-2-3. Take this off the runway. Oh great, there's a Is this a Ramos? Oh yes it is. Right, enjoy the takeoff ace. Let's keep ourselves above 2,000 meters. Turn off the navigation lights. Yes.
My first impression of Walker International was a Clarence International. There's like two airports. It may not be the base one. The airport reminds me of Vegas. No current players. Tower and the sunlight on final runway 01.
Looks like our descent is in order. Intermittent use of the reverse thrust. Now the runway is more to the right. Let's lower the landing gears. Let's announce we're confirming our landing. Clear to land, runway 01.
Oh, that was hard. Oh, what just happened? Let's turn around at this. Oh, Mars. Not great. Taxi to April. Center on top. Oh, and there's another Lockheed SR-71. Alright, so this one's a normal transport flight from Oconee Island Airport to Eagle Island State, Piaggio P.180 Avanti. Oh, look. Feel at this range. Once again, this is the Piaggio P.180 Avanti. Piaggio P.180 Avanti. Look at the new island. What mystery abounds this? There's some hangars, probably for general aviation planes. And this can be for the cargo or military. Yes, this should be the cargo and general aviation repairs, etc. There's only like one road to the manors. Oh, there's a plane landing? Oh, it's runway 19er. I thought it was 01. So this is 01, this is runway 19er. And here is the British Aerospace 146. Oh, I got my runway numbers wrong again. And it's the F-16. Yeah, F-15C. Alright, so we just pick up some executives and return them to their homes. Let's end the flight. So what's the... is there any different music in here? Now let's ask a question to this. I doubt he'll answer this question. Or they. And this is the new aircraft. The De Havilland Australia DHAC rover. So we'll just go to the dealership, and here are the statistics for this new trimotor plane. Where's my notes? Alright, so this should also be aircraft white. Alright, so what kind of blue? Oh, it should be darker than this. And yes, aircraft gray. Looks nice, mate. And the wheels are still white. Maybe in the game it's black as intended. Oh, it's gone. Okay, so that's just it. There's an Eagle Island. They remodeled Amaras and Clarence. The Embraer has been remodeled, C-390, and this trimotor plane. And with that, I'll see you everyone on the next Aeronautica video. One last look at the new island. And it's estates. Cheerio, mate. Or mates. I thought it was Australian. I thought it was British. Right, cheerio, mates. Oh, what the heck. A new game version is now available. One patch. Okay then, let's... As usual. Right, meet you in the next version, Mike. Hello again, mates. Short message. It appears that the music for this Eagle Island is still that copyrighted girl from Petaluma. That is all. See you on the next Aeronautica video, mates. Ta-ta!